your day start these days? I'll be honest with you, I'm a millennial, so for me, it's my Instagram DMs, my Twitter feed, and then my work and email chats. This means I'm basically working even before I get out of bed. And I'm not alone. How many of us start our days by scrolling through the apps on our phone or before falling asleep at night? Globally, the average time spent on the internet is 6 hours and 54 minutes. In the Philippines, where I live, it's 10 hours and 56 minutes. We are the reigning social media capital of the world. According to We Are Social, the top 3 reasons people go online as of January 2021 are looking for information, staying in touch with friends and family, and keeping up with current events. Based on this, we can see that people are actively looking for information. And I guess that makes sense, because we're living through a global pandemic and a climate of fear, anxiety, and uncertainty. And it's easy to get overwhelmed. Every time you refresh your feed, it's another steady stream of content. But this is how social media works. Algorithms learn from your behavior and feed you content that they know you will engage with, whether it's content that enrages you, amuses you, and so on. It's meant to trigger emotional responses so that you'll hit that refresh button, reply, like, comment, it goes on and on. It's called the attention economy because platforms and websites are competing for your attention. You're literally paying with your attention. Platforms grab your attention through content that triggers strong emotions like anger, happiness, envy, despair. And at a time of great uncertainty, we are exposed to emotionally triggering content such as bad news almost every day. A recent study done in China about social media and depression had a name for it: disaster exposure. And with social media, we aren't just exposed to disasters in our backyard. We're also seeing terrible news from around the globe. The study results showed that disaster-related social media consumption was significantly associated with negative mental health, such as secondary traumatic stress, depression, and anxiety. Now, I'm not saying that the solution is to pull the plug from social media. It still has value. It keeps us connected with our loved ones. We are able to receive support, information, and make meaningful connections. Especially during quarantine, being able to engage in conversations and discuss topics that mean the most to you and learn new information can be productive uses of social media. I'm not saying that we should turn away. Instead, to be able to participate meaningfully and mindfully so that we can still protect our mental health. I offer 3 ways to do it. The easiest would be to delete the apps from your phone and limit your online interactions to your desktop. This means that when you're not at your desk, you're not on social media. But for many of us, especially me who works in social media, this nuclear option is not a possibility. So I offer an alternative. Turn off your notifications. Notifications are designed to boost the time you spend on the app. When you get a notification on Facebook, for example, you might feel obliged to check it. And how many of us have checked the notification only to end up in an endless scroll? Turn off those notifications. You're not missing out by turning them off. It does not require your attention now, and it can wait. Second, your smartphone has built-in settings that can help you limit the time you spend on the app. It has a timer, and when you have reached your limit for the day, it will make the app inaccessible to you. This is a good way to limit the time you spend online. And lastly, if you rely on social media for information, know that there are other ways to source this information. Subscribe to newsletters of reputable news organizations or online sources. You will not be missing out on a breaking news tweet. You can read about it in your inbox with complete reporting versus bite-sized information that you get from your feed. Psychologist William James said in 1890, long before social media, "My experience is what I agree to attend to. Only those items which I notice shape my mind. Without selective interest, experience is utter chaos." I invite you to move away from the utter chaos that can be social media by engaging meaningfully, mindfully, and hopefully have a better experience online.